This would be the 279th birthday of Tom Payne. He was actually born on January 29th. So we're happy to be here to do that and to have some very distinguished people from our community who've done work that we consider in the living tradition and spirit of Tom Payne. So we have Toby Blum, Kelly Hammerbrand, Pierre Lavoisier, Nancy Armstrong Temple, David Red Welsh, and Amanda Witherspoon. Here, or someone here to receive them over for them, I understand. You can read this stuff later, you can see what we got for the program. There's a song I do every year. It's called The Ballad of Tom Payne. It's the story, pretty much. Tom Payne was born January 29, 1737, near the Norfolk County line. He grew up in Old England in a house of poverty, but learned to read and write because the schooling there was free. Oh, Tom Payne, if you could choose now. Oh, Tom Payne, struggle on the path. There was in the town of Dublin that young Tom Payne would play. When finished with his chores, he would dream away the day. At 16, he ran away from home and went to sea. It was in 7 years more that he had to be. Oh, Tom Payne, if you could see us now. Oh, Tom Payne, we'll struggle along the path. He came back to London, got a job with the government. He fought for higher wages and addressed the parliament. It was for this organizing that Tom Payne was dismissed. He had to sell all that he owned to get off the debtor's list. For in those days they imprisoned those who could not pay their bills. That's why folks who claimed the jobs in factories and mills. He went to see Ben Franklin to seek a helping hand. Got a letter of introduction from a genius worthy man. Got a letter of recommendation as a genius worthy man. Oh, Tom Payne, you can see us now. Tom Payne, struggle along with your back. He sailed to Philadelphia in 1774. The letter that he carried there opened up the door. Pennsylvania magazine. He was soon attacking slavery and injustice as he'd seen. Oh, Tom Payne, will you see us now? Oh, Tom Payne, we'll struggle on the bow. On January 10, 1776, he published a little pamphlet and he called it Common Sense. Well, half a million copies were sold throughout the land. Caught upon the colonies to the rising.